don't be like a dumbass and just to make a conversation and ask about stupid stuff that don't really matter or no one really cares about. Like, hey sergeant, have you killed someone? Hey sergeant, how many times have you deployed and seen someone blown up? Hey sergeant, do you know a friend that died because of combat? Do not ever ask that, because you're just gonna get yelled at, get smoked, and probably get punched. Got that? What is happening, guys? Artchisel here, and welcome to another video. Before we begin, shoutouts. First shoutout will be for El Rod Lomeri Rodriguez. If you don't know her, links down below or somewhere on the screen. She was at one point a future soldier slash turned into a future Marine. She's been trying to get into the military for a really long ass time now. She's been following my videos even before my comeback, when I was still in hiatus for like almost 4 years. And ever since, she has been watching my videos about my army stuff. Well, it finally came to a conclusion that I'm not really going to talk about the situation, but if you want to know, links down below, that she can't really enlist anymore because of some certain situations and things that I'm not really going to be talking about in this video. But please, if you watch my videos and if you kind of follow me or somewhat you like me, I guess, please send her some good words of wisdom or like something just to cheer her up. I know she's been wanting to join the military and serve the country for a really long ass time now. She's one of those people that really want to serve the country, but it just so happened that she doesn't qualify for some reason. So please check her out and let me know that I sent you, and that's basically it. Another shout out is if you like these shirts, if you don't know what this is actually a shirt from Unity Clothing. If you don't know what Unity Clothing is, links down below again or somewhere on the screen. I made a video about them. It is ran by Mr. Bradley Burnett, a good friend of mine that I haven't really met before. I had a chance to meet him at one point in Austin, but stuff came up. But yeah, you'll know if you've been following me. But basically, the proceeds, most of it, or a big percentage of the proceeds from these shirts, go to some places like the Austin Dog Alliance or places that he will be donating to basically help pair a veteran to a service dog. If you don't know, the government doesn't really fund this, or a lot of people actually need service dogs, especially service members and veterans that went through and have PTSD, but they can't really do anything, so he just made this thing just out of his own pocket. Basically, he doesn't really earn pretty much anything. It's just for the cause. Check out the links. And if you actually want to buy a shirt, I did put a promotional code down below so you get a discount, 10% discount and just free stuff. And let him know that Artchisel sent you again. And now to the main topic of the video, because I felt like it's been really dragging now. The topic for this video is basically coming from a question from a viewer. Viewer name is Adan Poras. I hope I pronounced your name right, but he's a brand new soldier that has been following me on YouTube that is finally here or is going here to Fort Hood where I'm stationed at. So first things first, welcome to the great place and embrace the suck. Yeah, but with that said, he asked me, what are the ways to get promoted faster as a fuzzy to a PV2 or maybe to make it more helpful for everyone, to you guys that's watching here right now, how to get promoted or how do you act as a brand new private in your unit? As soon as you get into the unit, you're brand new. I basically made a list on the things that you should do and what not to do to help you get promoted. First things first, be on time for any formations or any hit times. Not 15 minutes prior, let's just say just to play it safe. Go there like 20 to 25 minutes prior. You're brand new. They don't really know you yet. They haven't really met you or anything. So they expect you to be like in great motivation, like great spirits, and always there. You can't be there like 14 minutes before, because that's just going to set a bad impression that, oh, this guy's a shitbag. He's late. He's brand new. And it's the military. You're expected to be there before the high ranking people, before everyone else's. I'm sorry. That's just how it is if you're brand new. Another one is ask legitimate questions. If you're finally there, you meet your NCO, your squad leader, your E5, or maybe your senior specialist. Ask legitimate questions that you don't really know or you need help something with. Don't be like a dumbass and just to make a conversation and ask about stupid stuff that don't really matter or no one really cares about. Like, hey sergeant, have you killed someone? Hey sergeant, how many times have you deployed and seen someone blown up? Hey sergeant, do you know a friend that died because of combat? Do not ever ask that, because you're just going to get yelled at, get smoked, and probably get punched. Got that. Another one is expect to be voluntold. You are the FNG, the fucking new guy. You'll hear that as soon as you get to your new unit. You'll be volunteered probably to cut grass, clean the latrines, a lot of shit that you don't really want to do or probably haven't even done before you joined the army, and now you're going to be doing it because that's just part of the army. Expect to be voluntold. You're always there, even if you don't raise your hand or if no one raises their hand for some sort of detail, guess who's going to get it? You. Another one is earn their respect by working hard and not sucking up. I kind of talked about this in a prior video about fraternization and things like that, but try to work hard just to do the stuff that they tell you to do. If you have an idea, a brighter way, a more easy and expedient way to finish and accomplish a task, tell them that nicely using your military bearing with all military manners and everything, parade, rest, lock it up, and hey sergeant, I think it's better to do it like this. Chances are they may not listen to you because they probably don't care about you, or they will. So at least you tried, you did the right thing, and what's going to happen? You're just going to get smoked a little bit and you'll be good. Another one is as soon as you get to your unit, make sure that you are good with your PT. I know it's really fucked up, but it's one of the main points, one of the main things that they look at. If you suck a PT, they're going to judge you as a sucky soldier. I know it's kind of like bad in a way, especially how the whole promotion system is kind of like really flawed, because I've seen it happen in different units. Let's say you're a 300 plus on the PT score, you're on the extended scale. Yes, that's really great, but you don't know your MOS, you don't know your job, you're basically a sucky soldier. But some leaders just look at what's good on paper. If you know what I'm talking about, you know what I'm talking about. So just to set the standard, if you're brand new, just make sure you get good high PT scores because that's what they're going to look at. Another one is be smart and not a smart ass. There's a lot of these brand new soldiers. Don't be a smart ass unless you're part of the E4 Mafia. Another one is do not rat on anyone unless it's actually something serious that you can rat someone about, like someone actually tried to cause harm to someone. That's something that you can actually rat out because you're protecting your other battle buddy or other soldiers, but not about little petty things, you know what I mean? And because if you do that, they're just gonna come back at your ass, especially if it's part of the E4 Mafia. I'm sorry, private. That's just how the cookie crumbles. Lastly, to end this video, just continue to aim for progress. PT, college credits, college courses. So once you get out of the army, remember again, the army's not forever. It might be all hyped and fun, but it's never gonna be what your recruiter tells you or whoever tells you, because again, the army experience is different depending on where you're from, what you've done before, a lot of things. So that's it for this video. I don't want to drag it too long. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up. Make sure you subscribe so you get notified whenever I upload a new video. Social media links down below, and make sure you check Unity Clothing. Don't forget to use the promotional code. Don't forget to use the promotional code. Can't even talk right now. And make sure, let Elrod know that I sent you. That's it for today. Art Chisel out.